Namaste everyone. Commodity market is making so much news, and we find that our students are also very enthusiastic about this area. Now, since this field is emerging, it is very important that we all teachers should know about what are the new things which are happening. And I tell you, this market, if you see the Indian context, is over $200 billion. And if you see the international context, this market is over $2,000 billion. Commodity market caters to the primary segment of the economy because it deals with the metals and the agro. And in order to see what are the trends that are happening in this arena, and also to find out how do we introduce the commodity market education in our curriculum, we have with us today Dr. Tarun Soni. And Dr. Tarun is among the emerging researchers in commodity market in India, and he is currently consultant at Ministry of Finance as well. So we have the advantage to know about the latest from Dr. Tarun. And there I would like to ask you, first of all, that we heard about some manipulations in the market followed by regulators acting up, but could these actions start yielding the results, and what more we can expect in the future?
Very often we hear news about manipulation in the commodity markets, but let me tell you frankly that most of the news we hear, they are not true in the sense that many stakeholders try to, you know, influence the news agencies, and that we have a kind of perception that commodity market is like a satta bazaar, or there are more speculative trades going on there. But you know, after the FMC has been taken over by SEBI, and SEBI has the most robust surveillance mechanism, so it is very difficult to manipulate prices. Very often we hear news about manipulation in the commodity space, especially in the agriculture sector. I would say that many times the allegation defy fundamental logic. It's a pure common perception that commodity derivative markets are pure speculation or satta bazaar. Many times when prices fall, farmers and stockists attribute the same on commodity derivative markets. At the same time, when price rise, again many people start assuming that commodity derivative markets are fueling inflation. I'll give you a recent example of chana. In 2017, when the prices were falling, the farmers, you know, alleged that due to commodity derivative trading, the prices are falling, and the contract was banned on the futures exchange. But even after the banning of the contract, the prices continued to fall, and the decline was also in the contracts on the commodities like tur and urad, where no futures trading was there. So the main reason for the decline in the prices was excessive supply in the market. There was a bumper harvest of certain crops due to which the prices were falling, not because of excessive speculation on the commodity derivative markets. So this perception about the commodity derivative markets that it is a satta bazaar or excessive speculation is there, it is most of the time wrong. Second point I want to make at this point is, after FMC has been taken over by SEBI, it is very difficult to do any kind of manipulative practices on the exchanges. SEBI has the most advanced surveillance mechanism, and it has vast powers to act on those people who do fraudulent activities on the exchanges.
Yes. So that's a good clarification that we got. Now, one thing is that, as I discussed about that, there is a lot of interest as far as the students are concerned about the commodity market. But the question is that, you know, while preparing them, do you think that MCX programs which are being run, we can recommend the MCX programs to the students?
Yes, definitely. When I am talking about MCX program, MCX offers a MCCC program. So, it is an ideal program for the students to have a common understanding of the basic concepts of the commodity derivative markets. It tells us about various functions of commodity markets, various regulatory frameworks of the commodity markets, along with the delivery mechanism. So, it has a nominal fee, and it also, they also, the MCX also provides in-house training for the same. So, students can go for such programs if they are eager to pursue their career in commodity markets.
So, this seems right. Also, in the context that when we reach out to MCX, or even if you see their website, then we find that they are very open towards the commodity market education, and they want that more and more people, particularly the students, should learn about it. And whenever the institutes are approaching them, they are also reaching out to them in a very favorable manner. So, I think one thing that we can make out from this is that we as teachers can reach out to MCX and find out that what way we can associate with them for doing some commodity market related programs for our students. So, now Dr. Tarun, please tell me some more initiatives that management institutes can take to promote the career in commodity market.
Yes, definitely it is a very promising career, especially if you have knowledge of commodity derivatives. So, first of all, there is a need to create awareness among the students about the various career opportunities in the commodity derivative markets. Secondly, the faculty and students should read and discuss the commodity derivative commentary which is available from various agencies like Reuters, Bloomberg, etc. Thirdly, many students can approach commodity brokers for their summer internship program. So, that will also give them practical exposure about how the commodity trading is actually happening. Then fourthly, they can also consider other modules other than MCCP which are available online, which are available free of cost on the various platforms like MOOCs, etc. Then we need to identify certain organizations which have a risk management desk in their organizations. Many organizations, I would like to tell you, many organizations, they have a risk management desk. So, if students can visit there and see how they manage their risk, it will be a good initiative for the management institutions. Finally, I would say that awareness, creating awareness is important. Also, students like they can work on small projects related to commodity markets, which will be beneficial for them to get jobs in the commodity markets.
Okay, so that's wonderful. Now, I have also noted that you are among the few in India that have done in-depth research on commodity, and at NIFM, where you pursued your doctoral studies. The kind of work that you have done that has resulted into many prominent research papers in the index journals of good impact. Now, in this context, do you believe that still researching in commodities, as far as we academicians are concerned, is untapped in the Indian context?
It is quite true that when we compare the work done on the capital markets and the commodity derivative markets, the work done on the commodity derivative markets is considerably less, and there is a lot of vacuum in that area. And we as policy makers or various research institutions, they are, you know, looking for answers to specific questions. I would like to highlight few. For example, one important question is how we can improve the efficiency of the commodity derivative markets in India. Secondly, how Indian commodity bourses or the exchanges can be more efficient. If we see many of the Indian hedgers, many of the big organizations, they prefer international exchanges over the Indian exchanges. So, we need to, how, what strategies the Indian exchanges can adopt to improve their competitiveness so that the outflow of capital which is happening because people are hedging, the organizations are hedging their positions abroad, they start hedging on the Indian commodity exchanges. So that is the second important area which researchers can focus. Then thirdly, how to attract more hedgers on the commodity exchanges in India is a important question. We are also working on the same. So if we talk about the Indian commodity markets, the participation of hedgers is very less. So what strategies the exchanges or the policy makers can adopt to improve the participations of hedgers? Because when the hedgers will come on, the efficiency of the exchanges improves. So that is one another area which the researchers can focus on. Then another important issue is how to reduce the cost of delivery on the exchanges. If we talk about the Indian exchanges, the cost of delivery is very high. So what strategies the policymakers or the exchanges can adopt to reduce the cost of delivery is another important area. And lastly, I would like to add another important issue is how we can increase the participation of farmers on the commodity exchanges. Because idea of commodity markets, especially in agricultural space, came among the policymaker. The major aim was how farmers can benefit from the commodity markets, and that link is still missing. So what initiatives exchanges, policymakers, regulators can take so that the farmers' participation on the exchanges can improve? So that is another area which the budding researchers can work on in future.
I am very happy to note that you have mentioned that in the era of commodity, we have a lot of scope as far as the societal dimension is concerned. So that is something which I am sure that will interest the management teachers in India. Talking about the research, do you think that we have been researching related to commodities, and that is more in context of gold, silver and crude oil?
Yes, definitely the focus on the certain segments like gold, silver is more, but the international audience is also keen to know the basic trends of certain commodities which are specific to India. For yes. example, if we talk about guar gum, it is India produces 95% of the total world's production. If we talk about certain spices, India has a major role to play, and there are not very good research in that area. So budding researchers can take up those issues, and they can also work on primary data covering all the spot markets of the agricultural commodities. That will be another important area which we can target.
Now, the moment we teachers start promoting commodity market education among our students, the students would ask about the internships, etc., placement and all. So, what could be those organizations whom we can target, and we can try to engage with them so that it can help sooner or later in giving some career opportunities to the students in the area of commodity?
Yes, as I have mentioned earlier, that commodity markets is a very promising area, especially after the unification of exchanges. Earlier only two exchanges were trading on the commodity exchanges. Now all the five exchanges can initiate commodity trading. So recently NSE and BSE have also launched commodity trading. So overall, the number of people who are required in the commodity segment will increase in the future. Another important issue is there have been new guidelines by SEBI which mandates the organizations to report how much they are hedging on various exchanges. So from job perspective, if we are talking at the freshers or the entry level, the students can target various commodity broking houses and newspaper agencies. Then we can also target data aggregators like CMI, Capitaline, Cogensis, Reuters and Bloomberg. Then there are also opportunities in the Indian banks, whether it is the PSUs or private sector banks, when if you are talking about the higher level organizations, for example, you have a work experience of 5 years in the commodity space, you can also target policy organizations like IGIDR, Institute of Economic Growth. Then we can also target Ministry of Finance, Reserve Bank of India, SEBI. So all those institutions also want people who have good knowledge about the commodity markets. Then we have listed companies, we have agri processing industries like Ruchi Soya or Adani Group, which have their own risk management desk. So all these companies can be targeted by the students.
Very well mentioned. Do you think that is there some kind of opportunity that can be there with NGOs?
Yes, of course, there can be opportunities with the NGOs. If you have knowledge of commodity markets, various farmer producer organizations also have started trading on the commodity markets, and those farmer producer organizations need people who can trade on their behalf, or they can provide help in devising the trading strategies. And students with knowledge of commodity markets, they can, you know, act as consultant to those FPOs. So that can be another career opportunity for students.
Dr. Tarun, you mentioned initially about commodity market being perceived also as a kind of speculation. So one school of thought is that the commodity trading, etc., should not be much encouraged. Not totally be stopped, that is, not much be encouraged. Because on one side, this speculation is something people talk about, and another factor is that the awareness about commodities is low, and even the stock market that we talk about, so many years people have been investing, but still we have expressed our concerns about trading or investment in the stock market, that people don't know much. And on top of it, you know, commodities by very nature, if you see the price fluctuation, they are affected by very complex factors at the national and the international level. So in that context, do you feel that we should not too much encourage the commodity trading?
Yeah, in fact, this is a very tricky question, I must say. If we talk about commodity space and we link it with speculation, some amount of speculative trade is good for the market because it brings in the liquidity which is required. But excessive speculation is bad, definitely bad. So my personal opinion is a person should take position on the basis of his or her exposure in the commodity markets. So for example, if I have 100 ton of exposure of wheat, I am a mill owner and I require wheat every year, I should hedge my risk on the exchange to the extent I have my exposure. I should not take position beyond my exposure. People, you know, take it as an asset class. They consider it to increase their income. That is something which should not be encouraged. The major objective of any commodity trading should be price discovery and risk management. So the focus should be how you can manage or hedge your price risk rather than, you know, taking speculative position in excess of your own capacity. So that should be the focus.
One more thing I would like you to throw a little light on. That is that, if do you find that there is any other critical issue that has relevance for commodities market of India?
If I talk about the Indian commodity markets, they are, you know, still at a developing stage. After the merger of FMC with the SEBI, there have been many new developments. We have now more commodity exchanges coming into picture, which will improve the efficiency of the overall system. SEBI is trying hard to reduce the operating cost. It has mandated the commodity exchanges, all the warehouses, to register themselves with WDRA. So it is now mandatory that all the warehouses have to be registered with WDRA. One important issue is the awareness about commodity markets is very important. So we consider it is a general perception among individual that commodity space is mere speculation, and you know we need to spread that awareness that commodity market, it is not pure speculation, it is a tool to hedge your price risk, and all those firms, all those individuals which have exposure in the commodity markets, they should, you know, come and participate in the commodity markets to reap advantage of the risk management function which it has. So that is important issue which everyone should consider.
Thank you, Dr. Tarun, and I think dear colleagues, I hope that you would have got some glimpse of the commodity market in India, and we would be suggesting you some additional links through which you can learn more about the commodity market. But one thing is for sure, as Dr. Tarun also mentioned, the market is growing, and since the market is growing, I think it calls for all of us as teachers to know more about the market and also train our students that they can also learn more about the commodity market. And I think we have the institutional mechanism in place whereby the students can learn more about the commodity market. So thank you very much.
And